This is TWiT.
The vast majority of LIDAR sensors are time of flight sensors. You know, because all LIDAR is, it's a sensor that uses laser emitter and photo sensors to measure distance to an object. You know, measure the time it takes for the photons to bounce off and come back.
LIDAR stands for light detection and ranging. So it's just like a bat's sonar, but instead of sound, it's using photons.
Right. And so it's obviously a lot faster than sound.
Right.
But
I don't think, I'm going to guess that the new iPad doesn't actually have a laser in there.
Actually, it probably does.
What?
It's a low power, probably a 905 nanometer laser emitter.
Okay.
And,
okay.
You know, what it is, there's a lot of different types of LIDAR. You know, the ones you see on the roof of the automated vehicle.
The spinning ones, but they're doing 3D, 360 degrees.
Right, so
3D
those have an array of LIDAR emitters, and it rotates around and scans as it drives down the road, so it gives you a 360 degree field of view. But there's other kinds that are, you know, solid state that use a MEMS mirror system, like a DLP, basically, to do beam steering from the emitter. And then there's also something called flash LIDAR, which is a very low cost LIDAR. And what it does is it can use one or just a few emitters, and it pulses through a diffuser, and then has just an array of photo sensors. So it's, you know, kind of like a camera sensor, like an imaging sensor, but it's tuned for the LIDAR frequency for 905 nanometers. And what that does, there's no moving parts at all, but because it's diffusing one emitter through this diffuser, you're spreading out the photons, so you have a lot less range. And they say this LIDAR sensor on the iPad has only got about a 5 meter range.
That's pretty distant.
Yeah, you know, and it's fine for what it's designed for. You know, so it's a laser emitter going through a diffuser, and then you've got a sensor set that's generating a point cloud.
And the idea is it's really for, by the way, this is the website. Obviously, this was designed before the work-at-home orders because somebody put a lot of work into this. But what they're clearly going to use it for is augmented reality. In fact, they've showed videos. The guy who did the lava game for Apple Arcade, that would be kind of cool. You know where the carpet's lava? And the furniture, your kids probably play this, Lou. And you know, the furniture's your island of sanity, and you jump trying to avoid the lava. Well, in the hot lava game, you're in a world and you're doing that, but now you can make it your living room. You hold up the iPad and you'll see the lava, you'll see the furniture. You're not jumping, a little man is jumping. But I don't know. I mean, it seems gimmicky to me. Who wants to hold an iPad up for hours at a time?
He's given developers a path toward the glasses that are going to come.
Yep.
Originally in 2022, probably now delayed to 23 or 24. But the Apple augmented reality glasses are definitely coming, and all this stuff is going to make incredible sense. But they're going to want developers, they're going to want games, they're going to want all kinds of applications in place by the time they come out with these devices. And this is clearly a gateway drug to the eyeglasses of the future.
Yeah.